fucked up. I'm Mr. Perry. Oh, that sounds... Oh.
Huh, that's right. Happy birthday.
I didn't mean it. I really meant my back muscles.
21. Yeah, so we're starting off the day with some get some blood and the lats right here. It's one of my favorite movements right here. We're not T-bar, but pull-down bar. It activates the hell out of your lats.
I'm on a t-shirt.
Georgie! I'm a movie guy. Love movies.
Georgie!
Warm-ups.
My hamstrings are sore.
From yesterday? Oh, good. Yeah. You killed it.
Yep. RDLs.
She murdered RDLs yesterday.
RDLs.
Even on the warm-up, I'm getting blood already in my lats. Already. The key with this is the whole squeeze, man. This movement right here, I think I probably feel in my lats. Probably one of the most, the best ways of engaging my lats. Even my lower lats get engaged. I'm just warming up.
Oh, yeah.
You don't need a lot of weight with this. I'm only using 40 pounds.
Nice.
Full stretch.
One, two, three.
Music is not good.
One, two, three.
Who trains to this?
More stress.
One more.
Oh.
Oh yeah.
Yep. Already pumped. Already pumped.
Already pumped.
Already pumped.
Already pumped. Mine are getting there. Actually.
Yeah, I really get engaged in my lats.
Yeah, you do.
Same with your legs. You do one set.
Or my arms. My
yeah,
arms
squats, leg, or arm, yeah.
I do one set of biceps and I'm like, I'm done.
Yep, they just blow up.
I can't do anymore.
Super excited to see her back on stage this year. A year off.
Over a year.
It paid off.
Yeah. Yep. It's already paying off.
All this back work, training with intensity and volume, time and attention, has definitely paid off.
What do you guys drink today?
Creatine, glutamine. Oh, you reminded me. Orange Crush. Oh, let me show you. Dude, this is freaking amazing. Ah. What's in your gym bag? Bands, headphones, and Orange Crush. I might have touched this already, but remember we were kids? Those orange push-up things? That's exactly what it tastes
the
like.
Push-ups, yes.
Yeah, the push-ups.
Orange push-ups, so it tastes just like that.
Sticky.
Oh, here we go.
You're really going to start sweating now. That's my favorite flavor right now.
Oh, same. I love anything orange, though.
Oh, that's
orange
what you do.
Flavor, citrus. Oh, it's my go-to. The best color Starburst? Pink. Duh.
The pink one, Starburst?
Not orange. Orange is a close second.
What, Starburst?
Come on, everyone picks the pink.
The pink one.
Exactly.
You're saying if we had our own private gym?
Correct.
You have a resume process to
yep,
get through.
There'd be a tier system. Yeah. Two strikes, you're out.
Yep, back to Planet Fitness, buddy. Kick rocks. There you go.
Back to Planet Fitness.
The width is so much better.
Is this one of those movements you really hit for off season?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. With off season, we didn't do a lot of those are lats. We don't do a lot of weight on the lats. More like contraction, different angle, different contraction. Change our reps up, but we're not stacking up on the lat press, lat pull downs, you know, 3, 45s and all that stuff. But for the really big guys that can, you know, that works for them, sweet. I think for us, we did a really good job of planning our training around areas that we need refinement.
Yes.
Like for me, it was definitely arms and always lower body, of course. So we try to focus more on that type of training style.
So one of my main goals was my lats, my width. Mm-hmm. We didn't really go crazy heavy on like the lat focus movements. I think if anything, I had to almost think of myself like a beginner again and just kind of like start these movements, lat pull downs, these lat isolation like rows, just like I was relearning it. I really lowered the weight, which was hard to get over mentally for a while. I was like, man, I know I can do way more than this, but once I like actually learned to not use so much of my arms and isolate more of my lats, that was where I really started noticing more development, more growth. It's helped a ton, so.
I like my hand grip like this.
So you're targeting upper back?
Yes, okay. Absolutely.
Okay.
Full stretch at the bottom.
Okay.
Oh.
There you go.
Yeah. Oh. Could I go quicker with the reps? Sure, but I really contract the muscle. A little bit more.
There you go.
Full stretch.
Nice.
Oh. Five more.
Squeeze all the way back.
There
you go.
This machine is heavy and it's hard because the way the angle is too. Mm-hmm. I mean, the weight can pull this way up and then contract at the top. That's tough. Could I be your standard user and just kind of just go through the motion? Sure, but I'd rather control the pace, contract, make all my upper back muscles fire.
A lot of people have a tendency, well, in back movements in general, but especially with this movement, they have a tendency to use a lot of arm. So you play with the hand placements and make sure you're leading with the elbows. We're going with a little wider grip this time, so we're focusing on that upper back.
Grips today.
Oh, I'm using grips. Trust me.
Gotcha.
Oh, the Yeezy 700. Hella comfy, man. There's a wide in the front. Yeah, I'm a big fan of the Yeezy. Hella comfortable.
Air Max.
Air Max, right, yeah. Yeah.
My favorite.
She's a big Air Max fan.
I love Air Maxes.
All right.
Upper back.
Yep. Upper back.
Ooh,
there
shoot.
We go. Nice. That 1 second contraction right here, that's where it counts. These are really good reps right here. Here you go. Even if you only get 10 in this form, that's good work. And we're gonna do 3 working sets. 2 will be just like this. The last one will be a heavier set, but it'll be a drop set. That's a good one.
Damn.
Good stuff, man. Job. Hard work, dedication. Good back development. It takes, it takes years to develop a really good back. But you know, we're always saying all of our videos, nutrition's gotta be on point. You want to grow, Nutrition has to be on point. You can train here until you're blue in the face, lift all kinds of load. But if your nutrition's off, it's not gonna show externally. You may be strong as hell, yeah, but you may not have the actual look, the bubbly look you want everyone else to see. Yeah. We know a lot of strong guys. We know guys that used to train with them back in our old gym who are 160 pounds, little powerful guys, and they were strong.
Yep.
But externally, you didn't really see it. But then if you know what to look for, like the lower erectors, they were like bricks. Freaking slab, just bricks, man. It's crazy. When you meet a true powerlifter, man, you can just tell by you give a little dap in their back, you go, God dang.
Yeah.
It's like bricks. That Superman look right here. Shoulders all popping out.
We're just getting started. A lot of people need to realize there's a process,
yes,
to all of this, especially with building muscle, especially from a female perspective, because I know a lot of people in general, I think, have a hard time eating more food.
Yes, yeah.
But especially females have a lot of trouble, one, eating more food, and two, seeing the scale weight number go up. And one thing that I tell myself, and when I'm deep in my off seasons and I'm a little bit softer than I like, I just remind myself that there's a process and there's a season for everything.
Right.
And everything has its purpose.
Yep.
You can't stay lean year round, you can't stay competition lean year round. It's not sustainable, it's not healthy. And no one wants to be around someone like that.
No.
I don't.
No.
I don't want to be that person. So learn to enjoy every stage, every phase that your body is in. Appreciate what it is and what it's worth. And just understand that there's a time and a place for everything. Some of my most successful off seasons, I got bigger and heavier than I personally wanted to, than I personally was comfortable with, which is another reason why it's important to have a good, knowledgeable coach. One that is supportive, that educates you on the process and what to expect, and can also be supportive and give you reassurance and kind of go over, you know, how this goes and,
yeah,
and what we're doing.
Yeah.
I think that's something that we try to do with a lot of our clients.
Oh,
just,
yeah.
Just communicate, like, yeah, be realistic and also communicate what we're doing, why we're doing it, and kind of what our goals are.
Yeah, because you run into a lot of different people, we call it in the people business in general. It's because if you don't understand the seasons that we all go through, you can get stuck in one season and get self-absorbed or something that's just not worth even, you know, battling.
Yeah.
What happens, you know, you meet a lot of athletes who, you know, they get stuck on being the stage lean all the time.
Yes.
Who can't, like you said, mentioned before, who don't understand that you have to grow, the scale has to come up a bit. That's just no way around it. You can't stay, you know, stage lean all year long and be healthy mentally and physically.
Yes.
You know, so.
Yes.
You know, just have a good support team, have great coaches, and remind those type of steps, and you'll be in a good, very good position for success.
Yeah, and it's all about mindset too. Another thing that I tell a lot of my clients and what I tell myself when I'm deep in off season, when I think I'm at my worst, when I think I look my worst, and same thing for all you competitors out there, if you're deep in off season and you probably are not happy with what you see in the mirror, trust me, I guarantee you still look better than 95% of the population. Sometimes it's important to really take a step back, really understand, yes, bodybuilding is important to me, it's a part of my life, it's a passion, it's not everything, and it's not worth, you know, racking your brain and just being negative and not being happy. So think about that.
Off, and then I'm gonna tip another 10.
Okay.
All right.
Drop set.
This
we're gonna do 10 reps here. We're gonna drop the weight. You're gonna do 10 more reps.
Yeah.
This is our third set.
Let's get it. Lightweight to a giant. Let's work.
You got it.
Let's work.
1, 2, 3, 4, 8, 9, and 10. Just for 10 off, right?
Yeah. No rest.
Good, come on. 3, 4, 5, come on. 6, you got it. 7. 8. 9. One more and hold. Good. Good job.
Smoked. This is much harder than doing like T-bar rows of like 345s on there.
Hell yeah.
The angles, it's just really tough. Mm-hmm.
We can do this.
Yeah, you got it. At least 8. Nice. There you go. All this hard work's gonna pay off. Yep. Good. Nice. Sick. That stretch at the bottom right here too. There you go. Wait, 2 more.
8.
Yep.
2 more.
2 more. All right, come on. Yeah, 1 more. Yep, it's 10.
Oh my gosh. Yep.
Last one, yep. Good. There you go. Nice. Almost home. Good. 7, yep. Easy work. 8, yep. 2 more. Come on. 1 more. Easy work. There you go. Perfect. Good job. Good job. All right, rest up.
Yeah, that's hard.
Good job.
This thing's like a maze getting out of.
So.
What's next?
Which machine do you want? Do you want more of your lats? Do you want a little more back action? And more lats?
Lats.
All right, well, yeah, we can jump on that one.
Okay.
Sound good to you?
Sounds good.
All right, she wants lats. Lats it is. Her lats are nutty.
Shoot.
It's a whole different look from last year. Night and day look, man. Like,
yep.
For someone looking to grow, I would say, what's the old saying? For something new to come, the old must go.
Yes.
So.
Yep.
A whole different look. We're on this one right here. Go back to the way we perform lat pulldowns.
Okay.
So again, we perform our lat pulldowns a little bit differently. You might see in some previous videos. The bar is literally like, probably 3 inches from my face. Out to here. I feel the best lat activation from this angle, this movement. It looks odd to some, but you gotta try it. Sitting up straight, and I'm bringing the bar right in front of me to hold the bottom.
It definitely forces you to not use your arms, so especially for people who have a tendency to use a lot of arm in a lat pull down. I think that's one reason why where I really benefited from it, because in the past I always used a lot of arm in pull down movements. So once he showed me this, at first it took some getting used to. Like, it felt kind of weird, but. Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
And you know I'm doing it right too, because my lats literally will start shaking. This is the only lat movement I found where I put my lats actually shake and start to break down. It's all lat. Like you mentioned, there's no, my biceps are out of it. I'm using my lats to pull the weight down. My hands are just hooks. My shoulders aren't rolling forward. A lot of times you see people do lat pull downs, they're doing this.
Yes.
That's not doing anything.
Yeah. He keeps his chest upright the whole time. If you're crunching down at all, then drop the weight. Drop the weight and focus on keeping your chest upright and just leading with the elbows.
Trust me, everyone we've shown this movement to, they're like, I've never felt my lats get involved like this from doing this exercise right here. I'll challenge anyone out there to try it that way. I guarantee you your lats will be smoked and it'll be firing.
Yeah.
I'm not saying the old way is bad, but I'm saying you'll get better engagement by this way, this particular form right here.
And to truly do this way, the proper way, you're not gonna use a lot of weight. Like, I'll probably do 40 pounds. Versus years past, I mean, lat pull downs, I would easily do 100, 120. But like I said, using a lot of arm, probably using a lot of trap as well. Not isolating the lats. So you do it this way, you don't need a lot of weight. If you're really isolating and targeting your lats, it goes a long way. Yeah, it's different, but it works. It's kind of like I think of it as a hybrid between a lat pull down and like a pullover. I'm kind of like just hooking with my arms.